everybody, and welcome on back to Building with Whip. How are you all doing today? Today is a pretty fantastic day. I am so excited to be back here in our world, and today we are going to be doing some building again. Last episode, we took a slight break from doing some building. We built up these guys right here, but beyond that, we built up a kelp farm and started our Westworld-themed underground area, which I think will be super fun. If that's something that you guys will think will be interesting moving forward, be sure to let me know. I'm still in the middle on that one, whether we want to do it even more or not, or whether we should just leave that as a tiny, weird little futuristic area of this place. Basically, the idea is to create a giant, like, evil laboratory base, something or another, in a very futuristic theme underneath the city here, and have these entrances that basically merge that into the upper area of the city. So you can jump in and out of those places all over the world, similar to what you would see in the TV show called Westworld, as I mentioned earlier. So that's kind of a plan that I've been messing around with. I think it'd be something really fun to do, and I think it'd be something to mix up the world here. So let me know what you guys are curious. I'm curious to hear what you guys got to say on that one. So let me know what you think on that. There we go. That's how you word whip. Good job. We can word now. Anyways, today's episode, what are we gonna be doing? First, we're throwing a few banners around here to get our city colors around this area a little bit further, because I think it was lacking a little bit of that color and joy and all that good stuff throughout here. But today's episode, I want to be splitting it up into two different sections. First and foremost, I want to be coming over into this area and building up this small house right here. This is intended to be like a student housing area. So we're gonna make a small little house here that'll have a few rooms. And I think as we go up, we'll bring it out over the street a little bit so it has some overhang to it. So the second floor will be larger than the first one. And I think it'll give a cool feeling as you're walking through this area. You'll feel a little enclosed in this way. And as you come through, it blocks the castle sightline a little bit and then reveals this grand castle entrance as well. Then after that, what I was thinking is to add on to our harbor area just a little bit further, or just a bit more as we move out throughout this entire area. I was thinking we could come down in here and throw in our first small boat. We have those two big guys right over there. So I was thinking what we could do is we could take one of these small sections, maybe that one, or maybe the super small one over there, and build a tiny, tiny little raft sailboat or something like that. That's the plan for today. Anyways, let me get my head together. I have a decent idea what I want to be doing over in that small area. I think we're going to be working with a little bit of concrete today because I think it'd be fun to bring in like a whiter house or a light gray house or something like that with some wood borders and all that good stuff. So let me get that stuff together and I'll be back with y'all. All right, getting right into the building here, we have some pillars of oak wood stuck up on the corners to give ourselves a bit of a better look into this area, what it's going to be shaping like. And this should be the general size for the first floor of the building. I did also want to bring in some spruce wood along here along the base so that we have some form of like a divider between where we're going to have the white concrete coming in and where we're going to be having everything else coming in. I don't want this whole border itself to be white concrete going completely around the entire area. Like you can see here, we did bring in a oak wood strip right there. But what I was thinking was instead of that all over the place, let's move that one right here. Nope, that's exactly wrong for everything. And I was thinking we could use some white stained glass as our window bits in here to help bring in again that wider bit that we have going on. And then I was thinking this one could come basically all the way up here. And then on this one, we might as well bring in a bit more of that oak wood bit. And I think that'll actually help to add some depth and detail into the area. What I'm thinking is at this point, we start to actually bring this bit out towards the top and coming outwards. But I was thinking instead of right there, because we have that bigger, thicker point right here, that we could actually bring these guys out along this layer. And then on this middle one, let's leave that right there for now. Then just simply bring up our white concrete there. Basically, the idea with this upper level is I want to create a form of a walkway for everybody who would be on the second floor to be able to come over here and just kind of walk around and have a very, very thin area that they can walk around on. And I was thinking something like this could probably be a good fit for that. So we have the small walkway area right back in here where you can kind of slide your way in and out of it going all the way around. And that should be pretty good for giving us a bit of extra detail for this whole thing. I am running pretty low in the spruce woods here, so we need to make sure that we're making this stuff count. Something like that could work out, and then we can maybe turn you in to give ourselves a little bit more room there. And then on this one, we probably want to be doing that same bit as well. and then bringing you in like that. That should, we probably want to bring these ones down in here and something like that maybe. And you know what? Let's do that going across this whole way. It gives us a little bit more of a sense of it's coming out and up instead of just being a flat line right there. I think that's pretty good though. Let me get some stuff messed around on here and bring it back to daytime and I'll be back with you guys. As we know, we can only place one trapdoor inside of every single block here, so we can't actually create a perfect railing setup here, which is what I'm working on now. And what we can do, however, though, to mix things up here is basically with our railings like this, you can actually bring an extra trapdoor here in the center. That allows you to create a bit of a railing here. It makes that area up top being not very much, so you can't really place blocks up here, but it does make it look a heck of a lot better from down below. So what I was thinking is we could do something like that. Currently, right now, what we're looking at is basically everything right here. I did bring up this back point inside of here, just bringing up all the walls like that so we have our white concrete. And the more I've been looking at it, the more I want to bring some extra white concrete into this front area. So I was thinking around this window right here, we can almost just do all white concrete along there and then do something like that just to help bring ourselves just a little bit more detail and then maybe give it a bit of a crown right there so we get some more interesting stuff in here. I do want to bring some bushes along the bottom here to help break up that white transition into our bricks and our grass and all that stuff. This area right here will probably be a small garden or a pathway that'll lead back up into here and maybe wind around the back. Because what I was thinking right back here is a small garden would fit in really well in here for whatever this building's going to be. Not too sure on that. Anybody has any ideas for what we can do in this one, be sure to let me know. That being said, however, I have been more or less keeping the exact same shape for everything as we're working our way up to the top of this one. Let's get all of our concrete back here if anything won't jump out in the wrong weird ways. So with this one, I did want to just bring things directly straight up, and we're making the second floor is only going to be 3 blocks tall. The bottom was 4, and then we're going 3, so we're at 7 blocks tall on this. And what I was thinking was, for now, I just want to directly bring everything like this up here, and then from here, and then I was thinking, since this roof or this wall right here is going up pretty steeply, we could probably just bring everything in here. It will bring us to a weird even point, but if I can talk, because we're on a diagonal here, it should actually work out pretty well for us. So I'm thinking we'll be able to sell this one very, very easily here. Nope, that's the wrong one. We want to make sure we do white concrete, white stained glass, and then the concrete back on top. And this should look pretty good coming all the way up here, I'm hoping. We'll see when this one's all done. Let me get all these walls in place. Let me figure out a general shape for the roof on here. I'll be back with y'all. The creative brain is thinking now that we had this small area back here that was going to be absolute dead space. So I went ahead and on the second floor up here on this one, just popping everything out back an extra block using some spruce stairs back here to make it look like it's overhanging out. And I think that'll actually work really, really well for us. I don't like how flat and straight this thing is right here, so we're gonna have to figure out something to do with that. I've been working on this one some more, and I like the dark oak roof that we have going on at the top there, but I'm really not liking what's going on down here. I'm thinking that we want to add a little more variety into this one, just overall with the shapes of everything here. So I was thinking we could potentially bring this and reveal a little bit more of the white that we have going on down there, just so that we have some more information or just contrast and variety and not just a straight line of that thick spruce wood going across there. So I was thinking that'd be a pretty good way of doing it. And then in here, we could probably do something like you, and maybe on this guy, maybe on all of these, actually, we just turn them into upside down stairs here. And then maybe you become an upside down stair right like this. That opens it up a lot more, I feel like, and that probably does a lot better for us overall. It was just feeling a bit chunky throughout there. I do like this diagonal line as you're coming through here. Feels like a very, very straight, hard diagonal. And I think once we can add in some bushes, turn this into a nice little flowery area and everything like that down here, I think it'll look a lot better. Up on the roof, I've been using our pattern of just basically diagonal slabs going all the way across on this one. And I've been thinking, the more I'm looking at this one, the more I want to change this up as we start to inch our way up to the top of this build. I was thinking at this point, instead of just doing those one, like just half slab steps up, I was thinking we could arch this one out a little bit more and have it be just more variety to it overall. And so that we can bring up full blocks here now instead of just doing the half slabs. And it should look pretty cool with adding some extra depth to this guy here. So if we just come along this way all the way here, pop you up, and then this will actually bring us into a top center-ish point right there. If that'll even work, and I'm thinking we'll just get like a half slab or something on the top. So let me get this one in right here real fast. It'll just take me a sec to get all these dark oak blocks in here, and I'll be right back with you guys. The roof blocks are now in place, and it comes out to basically right up here at a perfect half slab. I decided to smooth out the top and round it out just slightly, and we're falling all the way back down here to reveal the next problem that we got to deal with. This area right along here looks incredibly bland and incredibly boring. You can see I brought a few oak leaves and dark oak leaves with me. We could, like, for example, we could basically just cover this whole thing like that and just completely cover the area with them, but that would be too boring. I don't like the idea of doing that too much. I think there's something that we could do that would be a lot better for this one, and I was thinking to mix this one up on this side. Well, for one, we need to figure out what the floor line actually is, so it's going to be right along here, and I wanted to take these guys out and bring in a bit of oak wood just as some, just like a small divider or something. So we have like a strip of oak wood going all the way around. And then I think that'll be matching up at the same point on these ones. And this should look okay. I don't think it'll look amazing, but it's basically just meant to be a divider in there. We can take a look at it from this side. And that helped it a lot. I think a few other things we could do possibly is, for example, like opening these both up to being windows. I think that can help the area out a lot just by adding in more variety to it, breaking up everything there. And that should help a bunch with breaking this area up and just making it more interesting. And I'm thinking back here, we can hide a very, very small window right in here. Maybe we can do a double wide one. I know it's basically looking into the wall, but it would catch some light out from this area here as well. So that might work out pretty well for us. But the last thing I want to add into this one is a chimney, which we'll be doing on the other side. But first, we can hide in this area a bit more back here with some leaves, and it'll help us mob-proof this area as well, because this one back here is a little disgusting, and there's going to be a lot of things that are spawning back here. So I'm totally okay with just covering this entire area back here. Oh, I broke my fern. I did not mean to break my fern there. Oh well, that guy can stay. For the chimney, I was thinking that we could probably bring it out right through here and just have it going up the center of this side almost, which would allow us to take a lot of U out and a lot of that stuff. And I'm thinking we'll probably do another window bit right in there just to extend that one out a bit further. But right here, let's just bring up our cobblestone right like this. We're gonna mix up the outside of this area as well to make it look more like this thing is actually a functioning chimney of sorts. And then, of course, here we do want to bring it out a bit more. So bringing it out allows us to get a little bit of extra depth, and that also makes it look like the heat is getting a bit further away from the from the building itself, which allows us to mix things up, and just overall it makes it look a little bit more interesting in my opinion. So we're gonna basically bring this guy right up here, and then we can do another chimney shoot right here to branch him off even more, and then just do a few more up like that. And I do want to get some wall bits on there, just some cobblestone walls, and that should mix that one up just enough for us. Adding in some last bits of detail for our house, and we'll move on over to the boat here. I wanted to bring in some oak trap doors for our windows here, and then bring in just some bushes on the edges. We can't really do this in the middle here because we don't have enough space to get enough of the oak trap doors in there. And they don't really need the covers on those ones, but I thought that'd be something that we could add in really quickly. And then here, I did bring in some more bushes along the back, and I think we can just easily add these guys in here. I'll probably come up with something else that we can throw back in this area here after we finish up the big structure, when we're finishing up detailing all of the ground areas around it. But for now, I think this house is more or less finished up. I like this one. I think we got a lot of good space inside if we wanted to do some work in here, because we can easily just bring in a floorboard right, or a second floor into it right across here, and that would give you a lot of good space for building room and building goods, whatever stuff you want in here. The idea was to have a bunch of rooms and just a bunch of different small student housing areas, but you could really throw whatever the heck you wanted in here. Honestly, this could be a small little shop, it could be a bakery, whatever you really want. It could more or less work because of the size of it. So up here real quick, we'll just throw some torches to make sure that we don't get any mob spawn. But that's pretty much it for this one. Let me figure out what we're gonna do for the boat, and I'll meet you all over there. Welcome to the docks, guys. So we were working on the house over there. I made quite a few changes to it, which we'll be checking out later on, but I wanted to get over here into building up our boat. So in this area, we have one block, two block, three, four, and one, two, three, four, five, six. I thought that was five. Okay, well, we're gonna leave this side being one little block wider. And basically the goal is going to be to build a boat right on this area. I want to make sure that this one is actually pretty small, so we're only going to be bringing it about two, maybe 2.5 blocks down inside the water. Wow, we are falling all over the place there. We're going to be using a birch base to this one. I'm actually thinking that we might want to move this guy out one more, just because I'm thinking birch stair, and then birch stair, and then that's probably going to be coming up to one more block high. And what we're going to be using for our second layer here is some spruce, because I want to use the spruce trapdoors to make this guy look a little bit wider than it is right now without adding too much extra, like, oomph to the build, if that kind of makes sense. You know, now that I'm looking at it though, I'm thinking down here we might want to almost just do some like stairs like this, and then we can quickly just bring this guy down here and just do half slabs along this whole way. So if we just did birch half slabs down here, or birch slabs, I guess you would call them, half slabs would be a quarter. Yeah, so if we do this one right here, that might actually work out pretty well. Then this one can actually just be some birch stair or birch slab. And then how long does this make our boat? I really want to build this one with you guys here, because I feel like a lot of the boat building that we do is me basically building the entire skeleton and then coming back and being like, hey guys, look, we got a boat. So this one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Man, we're going to sixes again. Let's do 7, and then we can do you right here and you right here. And I basically want to mirror this side on that end bit as well. So if we do a slab, a full block and a slab, and then grab our stair and do this, that'll bring us up to this point, which should be pretty good. Quickly, I'll just fill these ones in, and there we go. We got the center of our boat kind of cut out here a little bit more, so it should work a bit better. I'm thinking we almost might want to bring in some of these being some slabs and stairs right there. Now that I'm looking at it though, I'm thinking full blocks might actually be better. We could just flatten this entire area out right here and then have this being like the standing area on the boat. Now we do have this one over here, which we can turn into another stair right here. All right, I want to make this basically look pretty pointed going all the way around. And then out on this backside, we do want to do the same thing. So if we do like bam, a bam, and a bam, right like so. And then we bring down our spruce full blocks, and we need to bring in our spruce trap doors. I was thinking we'd do you and you and you and you. And so we're in there pretty good with these guys. And then if we bring in some birch planks right here, just as a filler block for now, just a very, very temporary one, and bring in some spruce trap doors along the side of this, that should allow us to bump this out so it looks slightly more rounded and slightly wider and more of that kind of boat shape that we're going for here. So basically the side of the boat would look something like this. And I think that'd be pretty good for the general size we're going for here. Overall, we probably can come to the ends of these as they're supposed to be pretty identical and bring something like this out on both ends, and that might help improve the look of it overall. And then bring in like a slab and a slab or something right there. And I'll bring this side in real fast as well. It's looking like a pretty basic boat shape, but I think it's something that we can work with and we can improve on here. The idea is to have a very, very small sailing boat that would basically just be going right out there, doing some fishing, doing their day's work, and then coming and docking right here, unloading everything they have, and then getting back out there the next day. So it's not meant for long distance travel. It's not meant for long distance anything, really. It's just mostly something to have as a local boat for people to work on, like the local guy who really, really lives in the area. He'll be able to do all that stuff. Anyways, what I wanted to use as the center block right here was bringing in some oak wood right like this. And we can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, which is currently what I have on me. And this boat is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it's 11 blocks long. We now have our conduit effect, so we can actually see in the rain. And then, so this one's 7. I'm going to bring it up to 9 tall, so we get a little bit more of that proportion in there. So it makes a bit more sense for how tall this one is. And I think it'll give us a better view. I do want to throw some fences and things on top of this as well to spike it up a bit more like that guy over there. Not quite that tall, but a bit taller. I guess it really isn't too bad seeing in the rain right here, so hopefully this isn't completely terrible for you all, because we do have that conduit, so it makes it a bit better for us. But my thought was, is we could take a similar approach to the sail that we did over here, like that one, where it's kind of that diagonal line, and I want to do that basically going at this angle right up here. I have a bunch of white wool on me that we're going to be using, and I was thinking we could just easily, to make it so that we can still walk underneath this area, make it so we still had something to go off of, is this one right here. Is basically, you can see it's connected at that end bit. We have that fence line going all the way up there, connecting to that top part, and then it comes down here. Then we have that bit of the line going right across there. I think that's something that we can kind of steal from this one and make work really, really well for us here, or my hope is that it'll work well. And I'm thinking, ooh, yeah, that's gonna cause a bit of a problem. Well, I guess no, we could Yeah, that's gonna cause a problem. Maybe this won't work. Maybe we do need to raise that up one higher. Let me figure out the general height for this one real quick and I'll be right back. I figured a good starting point for starting this one out here was to just come up here with a white wall and place it directly there in the middle of where we want this mass to be sitting, because we're going to be extending it a few blocks higher up there with the fences, and I'm okay with this white wall being a little bit taller than the mass, like beam itself, whatever that thing is called. No ideas at all. And then coming down here, we can just like drop this one down a little bit further and then bring it out to here. And that should be pretty good for bringing it out in this direction. This one's gonna be pretty thin as far as how we have everything going up here. Also, I really wish I had some shears on me right now so I could actually break these things somewhat fast. I think we, nope, don't fall in the water. How can we get up to here? Can we make be pro parkour? We are professionals. And then from here, so we brought this one down three blocks in that way. And then if we brought you up one and then two and then three, that would bring us up to here. I think that might be a good point to where we can start bringing some fences and things coming down. It's okay if this one's super thin. It is on a really strict angle here, and I don't want to look too thick and bulky compared to everything else we have going on with this boat, seeing as the boat itself is rather small. No idea why I brought four stacks of wool with me to build this tiny thing, but you know, that's fine. Now that we have the wool down here though, what we can start doing is taking off the bottom of this trapdoor right there. We can start basically bringing this back at an angle of, I'm thinking we probably want to do something right here. So it might connect through the middle, and then we can bring it spitting out the back of the middle onto this side, and we can connect this in and do it like over, maybe over like this. And that should be pretty good. It's not going to be perfectly in line with everything, but I think that's okay if the mass is a little bit swaying out to the side. So we could maybe bring you down like this. And we need to bring it back one more, so maybe we'll bring him there and then connect those ones up. And then the front one's already connected there. That I like that. I think we, I want to figure out how we can make this mast a little thicker. Let me mess with that one and I'll be back. After a few more minor changes, I have brought down the wool an extra block so it's just thicker going up and down, and I think that helped a lot. Messed around with this back little fence line here to make sure that lined up better, then brought in here for the center to make this thing look a little bit thicker. I brought in some spruce trapdoors around the base here, a small ladder going up to the top of this one with some oak trapdoors going around up there, so it's not just like a straight line. That could almost be like a pseudo crow's nest, that if somebody's trying to see down into the water better, they could crawl up here and then they can kind of shimmy their way around and hold on to whatever's up here, or maybe they can just like hang off that thing being some crazy sailors, whatever they're doing out there in the water. Anyways, next thing that I would wanted to work on was, oh, I also did bring in some trapdoors there to help smooth out this transition a bit more so the whole of the boat looks more rounded, so it's a little bit more rounded. I like the overall look that we have going on here. The one thing I did want to do was, I actually need some dark oak wood for that. Let me see if I have any around here. Of course, of all the shulker boxes I brought over, I just happened to not bring over one of the three shulker boxes I have of dark oak wood. What I was thinking to help bring this one out, make it a little bit more interesting, was throwing some dark oak buttons on the outside on these end bits right there, just to add some extra contrast into it, make it a little darker in those areas. Then down in these spots, I like to come in here with some, just some different blocks and things. And what here I was thinking was we could use some prismarine to symbolize maybe some fish. They have some like fish in the barrel here that they're hoping to sell, bring into the market, all that good stuff. And then to make this look a little bit more closed in, is I was going to throw in some oak trapdoors on the top of that, and that is not gonna work because we have the oak trapdoors on the other side of that block. So we're actually gonna rotate this one over to that side, turn everything around here, and it should work totally fine. But basically, you can just bring in some oak trapdoors like this, and it actually makes it look like a barrel of fish or somewhere where they're storing all the fish. Then because they're doing that, we do have to smooth this one out here a bit more so that it's not all super topsy-turny on the boat. We gotta make sure that the weight is even. So maybe we throw a little crafting table in there. Then we can have like a storage area back in here. And I believe we have room down in the floor to bring some extra bits down in here. Then what you can do with this is you can also, we don't really need that ladder right there. That's mostly just for show. And we could bring in some more oak trapdoors down into the base of this one. I think I lost that one. And then bring in some chests right like that. So you can close those chests down in there, have those, and then we can also throw another well of something down in here. And maybe this one's empty, so they're both closed down there and they're a little bit lower. So there's some area where you could store some more fish once this one fills up or something along those lines. And with that, it is time to call this episode quits. I think we've done quite enough work for today. After I left you guys last year, I didn't do too much work on the boat besides ironing out a few tiny little things throughout here, but I did come through and start detailing out the dock area itself, bringing in some texture variation along this area where it was previously just cobblestone going around the entire way, forgot a few blocks down there. Then I brought in a small cart here to move some goods around on the docks, as well as some goods that are sitting here on the docks. We'll add in more stuff like that as we go throughout, but I just figured we need a few little tiny details hidden throughout here right now. Let's just fill in some andesite there with that one. However, I found a great comment for today that was built right off of us building up a boat today. This one's coming in from Endtime. He's saying, what do you think about community-built ships to populate the harbor? Could give you a reason to make another contest. You could specify some sizes that would fit with the docks and make the harbor feel brimming with life. Love, Endtime from Nime. Hey, thank you so much for that suggestion, dude. I think that would be awesome. If that's something you guys are all interested in doing, as far as a contest goes, be sure to let me know. We do have a few ones if anybody wants to get started. This guy's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blocks wide. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. You got about 7 by 14 area to make a boat in there. Some type of a sailboat or a small trading ship or something like that. If anybody wants to make some ideas there, send me some pictures over on Twitter or Discord or something like that, and I would be happy to build your guys' boat in the world. And you can actually go ahead and name the boat as well if we use it here in the world. How about that? If you guys think that would be a fun contest idea, though, to get some sort of like a ship building contest going, be sure to let me know on that one as well. That could be very, very fun to do. So over here on the original build, I did mention earlier that I made a few changes. Briefly, before we get into this, totally spaced, Q&A episode next week. If you guys still got questions, be sure to let me know those down in the comments below. I'll be spamming you guys down there on Twitter and all that good stuff, too, as well, for some questions there. So, yeah, get those ones in. Now, more importantly, what do we do with the build? I changed the bottom here into some white terracotta, whereas the top is white concrete. Makes it look a little bit dirtier and more mixed up, and I think that works a lot better. I did bring in some buttons as well throughout. I know the sun's going down here, so it's going to get a little dark. And then back here quickly, I did add a few details, bringing in some hay bales right there, a small, tiny fountain area here that I saw in one of the castle worlds that we did in our castle contest. Absolutely loved this design and was looking for excuses to use it. Basically use 4 stairs there to create a small like box shape, fill it with water in the middle. Then on the corners, you do that stuff, bring it all up, and it looks like a great little tiny fountain. Got some more storage and just general goods and things back here, maybe some tools, and turn that into a bit of a rocky face there instead of just some dirt hanging over the... This looks super cool. Look at that. That is insane. That's such a cool screenshot right there. Anyways, that is going to have to do it for today. I hope you all enjoyed today's episode. If you did, please be sure to leave a like down below. Really helps me out with the growing the channel and all that stuff, so it's greatly, greatly appreciated. Please hit that subscribe button if you are new and you're enjoying what you're seeing here, and I will catch you guys on the flip side.